The problem is, if you're so anxious and hypervigilant, you're so preoccupied or otherwise in your head, and I've been there, I get it, but if you struggle with that, subspace will be extremely challenging, if not impossible to reach altogether. Honor is a hallmark of a healthy DS dynamic, and it includes showing respect, reverence, and admiration for the dominant. It involves recognizing the dom's authority and leadership, and showing appreciation for the guidance and care that they provide. Honoring your dominant includes using proper titles and honorifics like sir or mistress when addressing them, as well as following their rules and protocols. It also involves being attentive to the dominant's needs and desires and actively seeking ways to serve and please them. And I think two of the biggest ways to build a culture of honor in your dynamic are to speak it and show it. Honor is all about boundaries. Respecting the autonomy and unique needs and experiences of others. And it requires communication. Both dominant and submissive should be able to feel safe expressing their boundaries, knowing that they will be honored and upheld. I also believe that both partners should show honor, which very much includes respecting boundaries, but also showing value to the unique strengths and perspectives of the other. Another part of showing honor in a DS dynamic includes saving it. Okay? For you subtypes, this means calibrating and possibly saving your feedback or criticisms for a better moment, or letting it go altogether. Understanding that dominants are humans too, and sometimes the best way to show honor is to encourage your dominant to rest and be patient with your own desires. One of the biggest allures to BDSM for subtypes is reaching subspace or transient hypofrontality, which is that state of being so fully present in the moment that you may experience feelings of internal tingliness or floating, complete loss of anxiety and stress, time distortions, and a whole bunch of other physiological and psychological sensations. The problem is, if you're so anxious and hypervigilant, you're so preoccupied or otherwise in your head, and I've been there, I get it, but if you struggle with that, subspace will be extremely challenging, if not impossible to reach altogether. That's why it's so important for both dom and sub to be present with one another. But since this is a series on submissive training, it's a high value skill for a submissive to be actively aware of your own thoughts, feelings, and sensations in the moment. It means being attentive to your dominant's needs, as well as your own boundaries and limits, and approaching scenes or play with a sense of mindfulness and awareness, so you're able to fully immerse yourself in the moment without distraction or judgment or anxiety or stress or preoccupation. Presence also allows for a deeper sense of connection and intimacy between partners because you're able to fully engage in your respective roles as dom and sub. And you as the dominant can help your submissive get there with three practical strategies, including tasking or doing mindfulness exercises together, like meditation, breathing techniques, or yoga. Sensory play, such as using blindfolds, restraints, headphones, or other items of sensory deprivation to help the submissive become more attuned to their senses and present in the moment, is also a great option for you. And aftercare is always encouraged after a scene or play. Always, always, always. We always want aftercare. But when it comes to training presence, aftercare is even more crucial, primarily because of the emotional support and physical comfort provided by the dominant. And that can go a long way in helping the submissive stay present and grounded. As they experience an often overwhelming array of feelings and sensations after a scene. For many dominants, gratitude is a powerful motivator and aphrodisiac, right? For a submissive to show gratitude in their BDSM relationship, it includes expressing appreciation and thanks to the dominant for guidance, care, leadership, play, creativity. But it also involves recognizing the effort and energy that the dominant puts into the dynamic, showing respect and admiration for their role as your leader. Showing gratitude may involve expressing thanks verbally or in writing, as well as through your acts of service or devotion to your dominant. Three powerful ways to inspire more gratitude in your submissive is through training them in a communication technique I refer to as Oreo feedback. And just like an Oreo, the goal is to sandwich feedback or criticism between two positive cookies or praise points, so to speak. So you show honor to your dominant, even if you have to address something uncomfortable. An uncomfortable behavior, something they did to hurt your feelings, an accident, right? They happen. But if you have to address it, this is a great way to do it. I would also encourage a daily gratitude ritual and a protocol. Now, quickly, a ritual is a consistent behavior expected from the submissive, such as stopping at 8 o'clock every night to spend 10 minutes listing out their daily gratitudes. A protocol is a behavior triggered by the dominant's presence or absence, such as greeting the dominant at the door by kneeling and kissing their shoes and expressing a worshipful sentiment. We spoke earlier in this video about how to train a submissive to be more present, and developing mindfulness is of equal importance. Now, mindfulness and presence are related concepts, but they have some differences. Presence refers to being fully engaged and focused on the current moment. You're aware of your surroundings and sensations, and you're able to fully immerse yourself in the current experience. All right? Mindfulness, on the other hand, involves being aware of your own thoughts, feelings, and sensations in the moment without attaching judgment to it. It involves observing your thoughts and emotions without reacting to them. But you're able to notice them. You're slow enough, you're mindful enough with yourself that you're able to notice these things, and you're able to stay centered and focused in the face of distractions or stressors. Essentially, if presence is about being fully engaged in the present moment without being distracted by thoughts or worries about the past or future, mindfulness is about being fully present with and aware of one's own inner experience without being consumed by it. All right? And in the context of a DS dynamic or BDSM play, being mindful is about being aware of one's own physical sensations, emotions, and thoughts during the scene or play without being consumed by them. All right? Because feelings and experiences and sensations do become very intense. And it's very easy to allow those intense emotions lead your thoughts astray. So mindfulness is so, so powerful, such a high value skill. And a few easy but effective ways you as the dominant can help your submissive maximize their mindfulness can all happen during a scene. Easy, I made this one easy for you. Encourage the submissive to stay present and engaged in the moment by verbally encouraging them to focus on their senses, such as the feeling of the restraints or the sound of your voice. Guided imagery can also be a powerful way to help the submissive stay focused on the present moment. Use descriptive language, metaphors, positive affirmations, and sensory triggers like scent and sound. Using these tools, you as the dominant can guide your sub through a really transformative experience as they are so fully present with you in the moment. And if they get off track, if they forget, if they need a little help, providing gentle verbal reminders to the submissive to stay focused on the present moment and let go of any distracting thoughts or worries is also very, very effective and also highly arousing oftentimes. So these strategies will definitely get you started. But if you want to take a deep dive into submissive training, you don't want to miss my new high value submissive bundle on Patreon. This bundle includes 6 amazing downloads, including 2 brand new guides. Training Techniques for a High Value Submissive is a 6-page download packed with 50 of the most effective submissive training techniques across all 10 high value traits we've discussed in this series, with a unique 5-step training process to transform your pseudo sub into a high value submissive. The best part is that when you download this bundle, you'll also get lifetime access to my comprehensive library of over 40 kink-friendly worksheets and downloads to help you design your dream dynamic. Just go over to patreon.com/alexerotica to get instant access to this incredible new bundle. So don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell so you won't miss anything new. And if you try any of these techniques, I'd love to hear how they worked for you in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.